Okay, so the first thing we're going to need to do is download a wallet, or get a wallet. In this case, we're going to download one, and to do that, we're going to go to bitcoin.org/en for English. Now, this is what could be considered the official Bitcoin site, and it's going to always contain the latest information and resources. So this is the place to go. Now, I've put the link in the notes there. So we're going to go to Introduction, and then Get Started. And from here, we can choose our wallet. Okay, now, there's a number of different options. You can have an online wallet, you can have a lightweight wallet, a wallet that runs on your phone or tablet. But for this demonstration, we're going to use something called Bitcoin QT, which is the full software that runs on your own PC. Okay, and we're going to download it here. Now, as you can see, it runs on pretty much anything. But in this case, we're going to run it on Windows, because we're using Windows. So it's taken us to SourceForge, and the download has started here. Now, the thing to consider when using this is that it's quite resource intensive to download the blockchain. So, you know, it's going to take quite a long time. Probably you want to do it overnight, it might even take longer. And it's really designed to have your machine on all the time acting as part of the network. Now, you don't have to do that, that's entirely up to you, but if you leave it on, then it keeps in sync. If you don't, then next time you use it, it will open up and it will have to sync up with the network. But we'll see that as we go along. Okay, so let's install it. Okay, so it guides you through the setup. Ask you where you want to put it. I'm just selecting the defaults there, as that's fine for this setup. Okay, so it runs through and does its exciting stuff. Okay, and then it's going to run, so we click on finish there and let it run up. Okay, so it's going to need to go through the firewall to sync up. So in this case, we're going to allow access. I'll just close that down in the background there. Okay, so this is the wallet. As you can see now, it's got an icon there saying it's catching up. So it's telling us that it's 259 weeks behind. So that's going to need to catch up now. While it's starting to do that, we'll just have a quick look through what the wallet is. Okay, so the wallet tells us our balance, what is confirmed in our wallet, and what is unconfirmed. Now, when you send or receive bitcoins, they have to get confirmed by at least 6 nodes to be a confirmed transaction. And so, until it's been through those 6, it will appear in your unconfirmed. Now, all your transactions you can see by clicking on the transactions button. Obviously this wallet has got nothing in it at the moment, but we'll send something to it later so that we can see exactly what it looks like when something does come in. We've got addresses here, so it just works like an address book basically. And then if we want to send some Bitcoin, we have to put in the Bitcoin address here, and we can give it a label if we like, and then select the amount. If we want someone to send bitcoins to us, well, you can ask them nicely, we can use a new address for each different one so that we know who it's come from, or we can just use one general address. I believe the wallet can have unlimited addresses up to about 100, and then you need to make sure you back up the wallet again. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do anyway is go to the settings and encrypt the wallet. And you're going to want to put in a password of your choice here. Okay. So it's giving you a warning there. If you lose your passphrase, you will lose all of your bitcoins. Obviously, you don't want to do that. So it's important to make a note of it and keep it safe, or just use something that you won't forget. Okay, so it's got a close now to encrypt the wallet, so we'll let it do that. Then open it up again. So it's connected up to the network again, as we can see here, two active connections at the moment, and it's started syncing. Okay, so we're going to leave it there now, and I'll come back when it's fully synced up and we continue.